Hey people, what is up? Well, I have another knife here that I'm gonna ramble about with y'all. It's a knife that I've been getting several requests to show and ramble about, so that's what I'm gonna do. But before I do that, I got this right here. Now, this was a gift from my mom, and you know, my mommy bought me a blankie, and that's what it is. You know, when I was a little kid, I used to run around with a kind of a checkered, fuzzy blanket all the time, like Linus or whatever from the Peanuts. I used to always have that damn thing. And this right here reminds me of it, except for, you know, the pattern, of course. But this is burgundy, and I thought it would make a nice background, actually, because, to be quite honest, this looks like some king shit. That nice royal burgundy look. And it's just, yeah, to be honest, I just like the way it fucking feels on my skin when I'm laying my hands here, okay? Now, which is kind of weird because I like generally rough textures like the RTF2 on my Glock or, you know, Cold Steel's G10. I like aggressive textures that most people complain about. And whenever my nails and fingers get kind of dry, I'll take them and rub them on sandpaper, you know, just to get that grip back. Because I hate that real soft feeling. I hate soft soaps and soft water and all that shit. But yeah, I like the way this feels, so. Either way, I thought it would make a good background. I think it looks kind of good. I got the lighting up there overhead, so maybe it can, you know, we'll see how it looks. We'll see whenever I get this video off of this camera how it looks. And if y'all like this red as a background for my knife reviews, then I may keep on doing that, so whatever. Without further ado, because, you know, there's always somebody that's going to get pissed off that I spent the first 2 minutes rambling about whatever I wanted to. It's my channel. If you don't like it, suck my dick. So, without further ado, there's the knife we're going to be talking about. Now, what this is the Cold Steel Mini Tac Kiridashi, okay? And this knife right here is just badass. I'll tell you that straight up front. I love this knife. Now, this was a gift to me from a friend of mine, and I really do appreciate that, because I might have bought this knife, I might not have, I don't know. I like it, I like the way it looked and everything, but I just don't know if I would have bought it. It's not expensive, it's, you know, 40 bucks or less, and for that I think it's a hell of a knife. Now I'm going to tell you why I think that. First of all, you've got this carry sheath here, and it just does a good job of keeping the knife secure, real secure. No rattle, really. Little bit if you, you know, really give it that downward kind of thing right there, but it don't really do too much, and it don't go in and out, and it just locks in there good. You cover pretty much everything, so all you gotta do is get your fingers around there, you know, and you're pretty much ready to go. But it does a good job of retaining it. I like that, because the way I carry it is like that. You know, I carry it vertical, hanging upside down under my arm. I'll clip some of that video in and show you how I do it with this rig right here. And what it is, you know, it comes with a beaded chain. I just threw that back in the box. I don't use those. But I weaved it in, you see, right here, over here, and then back through and out there. Good and secure, not going to come loose. And I just did a little double knot kind of thing right here, so you can adjust it if you need to, you know, pull it down, pull it up, whatever. And it just does a few things. I'm around my neck, the double makes a little bit more support. You know, the thicker the strands or the thicker the support up there, the more it's going to feel comfortable, right? Instead of having a single strand. So that does that, and it allows me to adjust it, and the paracord's lightweight, and it's just a good system. I talked about this in my knife concealment options video, how I like to carry like that. So that's the way I carry it. I'll clip that video in on how I carry it right now. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how I would carry this particular knife. Now, it does come with a beaded chain, but to me the beaded chain was a little bit too long, and it put it right about here on me. With a neck knife, I prefer it to be right about here. But even still, this knife is a little bit on the larger side for a neck knife. And, you know, when you put it right about here or even here, wherever you put it here, when I lean forward or, you know, just move about, it kind of rocks back and forth like a pendant. And, you know, lean forward, it kind of pulls that or pushed out on the shirt. So I don't like to do it that way. What I think is a better way is to rig up your own system, and more comfortable too. I don't really like the beaded chains around my neck. I'm not crazy about wearing too much around my neck. And I like paracord better if I'm going to use a neck knife. The way I do it is I rig up a little paracord, you know, just an adjustable system, which I can show you. But I do it right here. Now, that has a couple of benefits for me. One, as I already said, you're not leaning forward and letting the knife, you know, pop about under your shirt. I like to wear shirts that actually fit me. You know, I don't wear real, real baggy shirts. I mean, if you're wearing a coat or a windbreaker or you know, just something a little bit larger, a little bit more, then it won't be a problem. Even still, in this one, you know, it's not really noticeable. You really don't know what I got going on under there. It does a good job of hiding itself under there. But what I do is I have it crossed around my chest, you see? Like just kind of thrown over my shoulder. And I have it right here. Now, what I like about this is it's threefold. One, you know, it's not going to move around here or around the back. It's not going to swing too much like it would if it was swinging along on your neck. So it stays fairly stationary. Now, it will swing this way, you know, like this. Just the sheath will swing. The way I got it rigged up, I think, is a pretty good way to do it here at the tips, and it's braided through there. But it does, you know, swing this way. However, it's not going to slide forward and back. That's good. It's always right there. So I just slapped the top of the sheath right down, and I got my knife, you see. So, you know, basically it's always going to be stationary. Now, secondly, I like it because it's comfortable, okay? It stays out of the way. It don't move, and it don't just flop around up under there. It stays over here out of the way. And I like it on my side, you know. There's a lot of different reasons, techniques I won't go into for draw, but, you know, with various types of knives, I like this type. You know, I find that I can always get up under there and get my hand on it and withdraw the knife easily. So that's just one of the ways I like to do it. I showed that in my, concealment options techniques or whatever, something like that. I did that video and I showed how I like to wear my knife like that. Now, you know, it's obviously on my weak side here because, you know, this is my strong arm, and I'll usually have a gun right here. You know, I'll have a gun. I have a gun here, a knife here, and maybe another knife right here, you know, for a week. But, you know, it just depends on what I'm doing, whatever. But this is the way I would like to carry it. And the reason I like it, you know, is it works, you know. It falls in line nicely with that system. Now, basically, let me go ahead and take it off here. Okay, so let's talk about the knife itself. Never mind the Securex sheath. The Securex sheath that comes in is good. We talked about that. But let's talk about the knife. Well, it's not a real big knife. It's a good size, but it's not so big that it's a annoying knife to carry under your shirt or wherever. You know, it's not a larger knife, but it's larger on the in the category of neck knives, in my opinion, which is kind of what they're going for with this. But, you know, either way, I like the size of it. It could be a little bigger, in my opinion, for the way I carry. As a neck knife, I'd want it to be a little bit smaller, but just it's all around pretty good size, and you can do a lot with that kind of blade. With that size right there, you can do a lot, because, you know, it don't look like it's that big just looking at it, but whenever you talk about that steep angle, and you got a lot of effective cutting edge coming from that angle, so it's really a good design. You know, Kiridashis are pretty cool like that. It's an Aus 8A, you know, what cold steel typically uses. Got your bead blasted kind of thing going on, not a problem. Really sharp, came very nice and sharp from the factory. That's good. You can always put a better edge on it, though, in my experience. But the real cool thing about this particular design is the handle and just the way that it presents itself. Okay, you got this nice bulbous kind of tail right here that gets in the hand and, you know, gives you something secure in there. So it's big enough to be secure. You've got this dip right here, allows for the thumb to be placed in there. And you've got this kind of you know, real heavy choyo with like what I call a trigger. That's kind of like a trigger because that's how I would hold it. There's different ways you can hold this knife. I'll go over that in a minute. But basically, you can, you know, really get a purchase on this knife, and you're not going to let it go. I don't see this knife coming out of your hand easily at all. Never mind the shape of the handle, which would be good enough in and of itself. But if you look at the G10 here, it's very aggressive. It's Cold Steel's typical aggressive, chew your pants and fingers up G10, you know. So I love that. And it's, you know, screwed on with a couple of Torx. Full tang construction. Good stuff. Good solid knife. And for the money, I just think it's a hell of an option. Now, there's the ways you can carry this knife. The ways, I'm not going to go into how you use this knife, okay? I told you before, if you've been watching my videos, why I don't do that really. I may, in the future, show y'all some things with it, but, you know, you can do it traditional, you know, like that. Just kind of a power kind of grip. And, you know, you can use it like that. You can use it to go outward, you know, like a kind of a slot or a filleting. Once again, if you don't like self-defense knife topics, knife self-defense topics, you know, this and that and the other, just, you know, fuck out. Go do something else right now. But you can use it in kind of a filleting method, up the arm, this and that and the other, you know, up under the chin like that. You can go reverse and just hammer that thing down right on, you know, here we go. On top of the skull, you know, temple, neck, face, whatever. You keep your arms in close to you so that way you're not extending yourself, and you just jab out like that. You know, you can jab down if they got something, they're coming at you with something in their hand, jab into their arm. Similarly, scrape up their arm, you know, things like that. There's a lot of different ways you can do this. And right here, you got, you kind of pull back like a trigger. That's why I call it a trigger. Kind of hold it right here like that as a trigger and put your thumb right there and kind of put that into the, you know, the whatever, this thing, palm, that little fat part. Put it like that. You know, and you can get that reach out there and just kind of a jab maneuver. So, you know, you got good options to grip it. You know, you can also, if you wanted to, you could come back here like that behind it and get a little bit more reach and a little bit more leverage on it if you wanted to. But I like this grip better because, you know, you get that secure, that finger just drops in there. It's the next best thing to something like a karambit or something with a full hole where you put your finger in. And a benefit of this one, let me just go grab one. Hold on a minute, because I'd like to visually tell y'all or show y'all. Let me grab this one. I'm going to grab my karambit. I'll grab this bear claw. Something like this. If you got your finger in there, now, in my particular brand of study, we train to disarm as well. Now, if someone had something like this, and or, you know, you say, and someone were to disarm you or attempt to let's say, attempt to disarm you. Excuse me, y'all. Let me get a drink. Throat's getting dry. Much better. Okay, let's try that again. If someone were to attempt to disarm you by pushing the blade back, and, you know, you didn't have a secure enough grip down here to resist that, what's going to happen is they're going to end up breaking your damn finger, okay? Or worse yet, if someone were to somehow procure your handle and your finger's in there, you got problems, okay? So it's a good design in that you can retain the knife well, but what you'll see me do, rather than sink my finger in there deep like that, you'll see me usually putting my finger like this. So if someone were to do that, I can get my finger out of there. That's how you usually see me whenever I have a blade like that. This one, however, if that were to happen, you know, you can let it go. There's nothing that is going to grab your finger and break back. Now, you really don't want to let your knife go and give it to the hands of your attacker. That's not a good thing. But my point is, it's better than having your finger broke, because, you know, a broken finger can be a big problem when you're defending your life. You know, they break your hands and stuff. You don't want to be out of commission, so you want all your faculties intact. But anyway, that's my point about that. You got a few holes here. They look pretty cool. Give you a little weight reduction. They could have left them off or, you know, put them there. Either way, I don't care. It was kind of nice, though. You could put a lanyard on there, I guess, if you wanted to. I don't really see the need, you know, because once you get on that sheath and ride your hand down, once you get about right here, you can just withdraw. So, good stuff. It shares the same things I was talking about if you watched my Yojimbo 2 review. I talked about the Warncliffe. This is a Kiridashi, but, you know, I talked about the straight-bladed physics a little bit and how, you know, it cuts like this. You know, that's the part you're going to get in first. It's not so much where you draw through it. It's more you get the tip in and then power into it, or also a scraping method like this. You know, so there's just basically a good amount of things you can do with this style of knife. You know, the handle, the Kiridashi is good. They also offer it in a, hold on a minute, y'all. Let me grab my internet up here. They got a beaver tail kind of blade. Big old fat blade. Looks like a leaf shape, kind of like Spyderco's leaf shape. And they have a Skinner type blade, you know, like the Espada looking curvature upward, you know. So they have those available as well if you like that better. I happen to like the Kiridashi. Now, I didn't pick this. A friend of mine sent this to me as a surprise, and he picked the one I would have picked if I would have got any of the cold steel mini tacks, because this is the one that I really, you know, just I like this one the best. I'm a big fan of that straight bladed performance, you know. And you know, I get people taking me to task on it. They say, well, you know, about the not necessarily taking me to task, but just disagreeing about the straight bladed performance. But you know, as far as a defensive knife, I like that. Because, for one, you know, you got penetration on this blade. I mean, that thing, look at that. The penetration capabilities of this are just second to none. It's ridiculous. And then once you do, you still have that nice edge that's going to, you know, you can get in there and get right back out of there, or you can get in there and push. You know, it's just, it's a devastating blade shape. So, I do like it. The jimping on the back, or it's more scalloping. It does, like, once you get flat on it, you can kind of purchase into it. But, you know, it's not really real aggressive. It's done well. It's really nicely done. You know, the machining on it's good. No bullshit going on. You look at the machining through the G10, it all lines up good. The handles are well done. Everything's nice and uniform. See if I can get y'all a macro of it. Come on. See on the back there, very smooth, nothing rough all the way around. The whole knife just is really well done. Now, I'm not the biggest fan of stone washing. You know me, I prefer a nice, or not stone washing, excuse me, bead blasting. I prefer a nice stone washing, or, you know, just seeing the natural satin grind, but it's not a problem. And it's actually more, it's not really a bead blast. Like if you look at Kershaw's, this one's more of a coating almost. It's a bead blasting. But it's still, if you look at it real close, you can see some of the grind in there. So, you know, it's nice looking. It looks nice and uniform. No problem there. You know, as far as rust, I'm not worried about it because I keep my blades oiled. You know, I never really have a rust with any of my Aussade or anything like that. So, you know, not a big deal. I prefer this to Kershaw's bead blasting. But I still would prefer a nice stone washing on that, or, you know, just a satin. Or even all black, a black coating. You know, I'd really like it if Cold Steel would start doing the DLC coatings and stuff like that. You know, I'd pay the extra. I've said that a lot. I'd pay the extra on it. This in all black, I think it would be nice. It might kind of lend to the oh shit, you know, scare the sheeple factor a little bit. Being all black like that with this blade shape, it, you know, whatever. People have their own opinions, but a nice DLC on this wouldn't be bad. A stone washing, easy enough. I could do a stone washing myself. Just pop them handles off and throw it in there. But all in all, I really do like the knife, and I really think it's a great option for a defensive knife to carry on you. It's not too big, not too small, right about perfect for me personally. Okay, and I do like knives like this, Hawkbills. I think they're exceptionally formidable. The Steel Tiger and stuff, those are larger knives though. If you wanted to have something fairly low key, something that's, you know, a good hideout knife, you know, whatever, I think this is a good option, you know, and you got a healthy blade there that can do a lot. So I'll quit rambling about it, but I've been getting requests for me to tell you what I think about this knife, and what I think about it is good. It's not an EDC everyday kind of knife. I guess you could use one as that. Like I said, they have the kind of beaver tail leaf blade and the other tack skinner or mini tack skinner kind of blade. And I think those would be better for EDC. They got more belly. You know, this one is purely a self-defense type of design, in my opinion. You know, can you use it for EDC? Sure. You know, you could chop up stuff just like I talked about on the Yojimbo 2 review. You know, it make a good little chopper, and, you know, it got a decent edge, or a better than decent edge. It got a great edge and a good point if you need an EDC knife with those capabilities. And, you know, I think this would do good in that respect, if that's what you need. For me, this is purely self-defense. I'm never going to touch it. I'm not going to pull it out to cut whatever I got to cut, unless it's someone trying to attack me. And I'm going to keep it razor sharp, point good to go, and just keep it hidden out on me. In the unfortunate, God forbid, event that someone were to attack me, that's one I'd not mind having to defend myself with. And I'm very capable with a knife of that size. A lot of people may think that, you know, you really can't do much with a knife blade of that size. I beg to differ. I beg to differ. And I'd hate to have to prove it. But either way, that's enough rambling. I'm going to get out of here, y'all. Tell me how y'all like the King shit right here. The nice royal background. Anyway, so that's it, y'all. Life's short. Stay sharp.